Since the beginning of time, the Earth's surface has shaped human life. The effects of elevation are essential to where and how we live, the risks of living where we do, and the impact we have on the local environment. Digital elevation data helps us interpret and analyze physical features of the landscape for scientific studies. It allows us to see the surface of the Earth in three-dimensional views.
Elevation data has been an important component of the U.S. Geological Survey's topographic map since the 1880s. A topographic map without elevations in the form of contours is simply not a topographic map. Digital elevation models, or DEMs, are collected into a single multi-resolution dataset known as the National Elevation Dataset. As the elevation source for the national map, the NED provides up-to-date bare earth data that describes the Earth's relief.
LiDAR is the NED's primary source of new elevation data. It's cost-efficient, more accurate, and it captures data points from the Earth's surface to the tops of the features above and in between.
Its use goes beyond topographic mapping into other areas of science and into everyday life.
FEMA produces flood insurance rate maps that let homeowners know what their risks are of flooding, and LiDAR is essential in making accurate flood maps. Now, FEMA uses hydrologic modeling and hydraulic modeling for their flood studies. The credibility of the National Flood Insurance Program is largely based on the credibility of the elevation data used to produce those flood studies. FEMA computes the water surface elevations for standard flood events, such as a 50-year flood, a 100-year flood, a 500-year flood. What the homeowner wants to know is, what is their risk of flooding? How the special flood hazard area changes depending on whether or not you used accurate LiDAR data in that flood study. New flood studies done with more accurate LiDAR data tells more people they need to buy flood insurance, or in some cases, fewer people need to buy flood insurance. LiDAR is the basis for making flood maps accurate.
In the fall of 1999, Hurricane Floyd hit North Carolina. It was one of the most damaging storms in recorded history. Particularly, flooding caused most of the damage. At that time, LiDAR was just emerging as a potential technology for collecting accurate elevation data very quickly. One important lesson learned from the North Carolina project was there were many, many other potential users of the data. And to find a way to archive, store, distribute, make all that data available in an efficient way really challenged the existing infrastructure. And that's where the USGS really had an important role to play because of their experience with managing large amounts of data over large areas and distributing it to the public.
And one thing about LiDAR that's also amazing is everything is in the right place. You know, it's in its true location natively. So it's 3D and it's in the right place. With this, it totally revolutionized the way that we measure forest lands, because now we have a tool that gives us everything we need. How do we manage this forest? How do we, based on the density of certain kinds of vegetation, how do we best manage it for certain kinds of wildlife habitat or an endangered bird species habitat? When we look at where we are today, when we start to consider things like climate change, when we start to think about where the carbon is in the forest, you know, we now have some reliable information that we can actually use to drive the science to determine how do we mitigate these problems.
Through support and partnerships, the elevation data available to the national map continues to grow and improve, but we have a ways to go. A federally funded assessment is currently underway to better understand the requirements, costs, and benefits across all levels of government and business for elevation data. Beyond helping to lessen the impact of natural catastrophes, new and improved elevation data fosters new scientific uses and applications that eventually filter down to the general population. Fostering the use of this data is the goal of the elevation program of the National Map.
Go to nationalmap.gov to learn more about how to use elevation information or to become a valuable partner.